Good morning. Sorry, bye for this late. Let me just take a quick attendance. I don't know why the connection is too bad. Anyway, let's start and then later I will take the attendance. We say that in fluids that we have a static force. First part of the static force is the pressure that will come from the head of the water that we have, a column of water. So how much is the column of the water there will be? There will be a pressure, and how much is the value of this pressure is called static force. For example, if you have this column of water, so the weight of this column of water will make a pressure on the bottom on this point, and the value of this pressure is equal to gamma H, or this is called pressure at this point. Remember that we have atmospheric pressure, and here's the atmospheric pressure. The atmospheric pressure is, for example, if you have liquid, this is the depth of the liquid. So we have this is the depth of liquid over this point. So let me say this is any kind of oil or any liquid. So there will be the pressure on this bottom, and I will see, I want to see how much is the pressure at point one. So there will be two kinds of pressure. One is the from the depth of this liquid, and this is will be called as a static pressure, or this static pressure, or it's called gauge pressure, P gauge. So we say that it's called gamma H. Now there is another pressure above this point, which is atmospheric pressure. Then there will be atmospheric pressure, and we say that this atmospheric pressure is equal to 101.3 kilopascal, or kilonewton per meter square. Now, or one bar, that is called the atmospheric pressure. The adding both of them, total pressure, is the amount of the total pressure that we have, which is the gauge pressure plus the atmospheric pressure. Now, if I want to see how much is the total pressure will be on point one, so there will be two pressures on this one, the first static pressure plus the gamma H, and there will be this point. Now we say that, this is in the previous lecture, we say that at this point, then there will be a pressure in this way. And we said by Pascal's law, the pressure from any direction will be the same at any point. So this is will be equal to that pressure, which is will be from this side, will be this is from each side, this side. So if you have one of the pressures, then you can say that this pressure is the same as lateral, vertical, horizontal. That's the law of the Pascal's law. So Pascal's law say that, Pascal's call that the pressure from every point, so P at X from X direction will be the same as a P of Y direction will be the same as a P from Z direction, which will be equal to that P. Which P? The P that we know it's a total pressure, which is equal to atmospheric pressure plus gauge pressure. Okay, now this is in case that we have the liquid is open to surface, open to air. Now you can see there is only the pressure that comes from the atmosphere. So what if I have open, it's called open to air. What if I have, what if I have a, what if I have a closed, for example, not to open to air, for example, a closed container. If I have a closed container like this, if I have, this is a, could be closed container. We say that there will be any amount of water that will go raise this raise. There will be a liquid and there will be a pressure at this point. So, and this raise by from capillary. Capillary force, it make the liquid to go up. That's what we see that is due to the edge. Anyway, the pressure at this point will be the head, this overall, that the gauge pressure is equal to gamma of overall y. And there is another way, there is another pressure that will act, but it will not let the pressure, it will be inverse the direction of the this gauge pressure. So that means the total pressure will be the gauge pressure minus the V vapor. So this is called vapor pressure. And the vapor pressure is not acting like atmospheric pressure. It will be inverse of the atmospheric pressure. That was another point that we have in calculating the pressure. The other point that I have, if I have a multi-layer, for example, multi-layer liquids like this, this is could be oil, this is could be water. And if I wanna see how much is the pressure at this point, so find the pressure at point one. So it means you have to calculate, this is interface. So you have to have the pressure from the oil itself and from the water itself and add them together to get the total pressure. So pressure at point one, or let me say the gauge pressure at point one. By the way, if I didn't mention that I said that find the pressure at point one. So usually you will find the gauge pressure at point one. If I didn't mention that, please find the absolute pressure, then you don't need to add atmospheric pressure. But usually I will ask you to find the pressure at point one. Since you don't need to add any other pressure. But if I say that, okay, find the total pressure at point one, total, or absolute pressure. So you have to, after have calculating the gauge pressure, you have to add it at the atmospheric as well. Now, pressure of 0.1, if I have multi-layer fluids, what will be equal? It will be equal to the pressure that comes from the oil itself plus the pressure that comes from the water itself, separate. Now, why I'm doing that, because everyone is equal to its, so if you stand here, there will be a column of oil above that point. So that means we have a gamma H oil. Which gamma? Gamma of oil itself, plus. And I have, when I stand here, there will be a column of water, which is equal to gamma water plus the H of water. And plus, any other layers that you have, you have to add them together, and you can find that this is called the peer pressure of 0.1. So that's why we have sometimes also another kind of maybe saturated soil. We have to add them to this part of our liquid. This is the summary that we have. And we have another thing that we have also from Pascal's law. It said that if you have a point in the same level. So if I have, for example, 1, 2. So Pascal's level also say that, yes, you can say at any point, the direction of the pressure will be the same, Px equal to Py equal to Pz, for example, equal to any P. That's correct. This is one of the findings of Pascal. There's another one from Pascal's law. It says that if you have a liquid in the same level and in the same condition, that means that they have in a closed system. So if I have P1 here and there is a point one, there is an area here, and there is, I mean by P means by force. P1. Yeah. So P1 over A1. That means, sorry, this is F, not P. Pascal say that if you have force here, which act on this point, with this point, in this point, we have an area, and the area is equal to area one. It will be the same thing that we have here, force two over the area two. What that means, it means that F1, which is the force at point one, divided by area one. So force divided by area will give you a pressure, right? So that will give you a pressure at point one. Now, this is also pressure at point two will equal to force at point two divided by area of two. The finding of Pascal said that you can say P1 will equal to P2. That means what? That means you can use this kind of relation to find, for example, to use as a jack, a small area you need to lift a car. So you need an area that is for having a car. Now you can use just a handle just to lift that car. That's the basics of the Pascal's law. Now, this was the theory of the statistics, and I think we are covering all of them. Now we need just to go with the examples and solving them, okay?
Sir?
Yeah?
With the example that you said, P1 times the pressure at 0.1.
Yes.
If you ask for absolute pressure, do you have to add atmospheric pressure?
Yeah, and I say when I'm asking you to find the only just the pressure at that point, so that means I'm just asking to find the gauge pressure. But if I ask you to find the absolute pressure at point, so you mean that you have, after finding the gauge pressure, add to the absolute the atmospheric pressure at that point. Okay. Yeah, there is another thing that before going to that one, which is the manometry. I will come with this one after solving the, some of the examples. So I think, was it clear? That was the gamma pressure. Now look at this one. This is a very simple example. We say that, I think we solved this example, right? Okay, again, now I wanna see how much is the pressure at this point. If I wanna ask, this is the pressure at the bottom of this ocean. This ocean is about 4.6 kilometers depth. So there will be, and the gamma is not 9.81 because it's a saline water. And that's why we have a 10.05. Now the pressure is will be equal to the gamma H. How much is the H? We have the H is 4.6 or 4,600 meter. And this is in kilonewton per meter cube. So the result will be kilonewton per meter square, which is kilopascal. Now, if I wanna say this is the gauge pressure, if I told you that I wanna see how much is the absolute pressure, you just need to add the 46,700 kilopascal plus atmospheric pressure, which is 103.3 kilopascal. That means equal to 800 801.3 kilopascal. That will represent a value which is called absolute value. Okay. Now, look at this. Is the this is a stream, and we have a pipe that's going under the stream. Means there will be a pressure on that one, and we have a valve. We close the valve, for example, here. There will not be outflow. This is the water is, let me say, pressurized in this pipe, and there will be a valve here. So there's no movement. The water is just, we say that we, there will be inside this pipe. This is a pipe. And we have a rod, we have a stream anyway. So I wanna see where underground oil, and this is an oil pipeline, not a water, is in a galley, it's called galley. We have, it is 68 deeper. So how much is the pressure at this point? So you have to think there will be 68 feet deeper in this way on the, okay, then Issa. So we have the pipe is laid under the galley by 68 feet on each side. So we have here 68 and also here 68. The specific gravity of oil is how much? 0.88. Why we need that specific gravity? Because you can see the specific gravity. We have a pressure on this one. There will be, this oil is, you have to push that oil from this part to this part by having a pressure, right? So how much is the pressure? We have 32 Pascal. Now, the pressure here is 32 PSI, not Pascal. I wanna see how much is the pressure that will act on the bottom. On the pipeline itself, when it is, here is 0.2. So the idea is that we have this point, we have this point. The pressure on this point is 32 PSI, okay? Now we have a column of oil. That's also, remember that due to Pascal's law, the pressure at this point, it will be the same pressure at this point because they are on the same level or the same the same elevation. Now, so we have 32 psi at this point. Also, we have a column of oil that's 68 feet from this point to that point. That's the point at, let me say, this is point two. So what is required? The required is to find the pressure at point two. So pressure at point two is equal to how much? Knowing that we have pressure at point one, which equals 32 psi, pound per square inch, plus we have 68 feet. So what to do? I'm just adding both of them together to get this back. So the idea is that this is, was the oil pipe. And I have, here's 30, how much it was? 32 psi at 0.1. And I want to see how much at 0.2. 0.2, it means here the point. We have 68 feet oil. Which oil? Which is the specific gravity is equal to 0.88. Now, pressure at 0.2 is equal to pressure at 32 psi already is there. We have a pressure on this surface, plus what will be else? What will be the depth of oil? How much is the depth of oil? 68. Now gamma H will give me another pressure, which is, how much is the H? H is 68 feet times the gamma of what? Gamma of oil. Now, gamma of oil is equal to specific gravity of oil times gamma of water, right? Now, 32 psi plus gamma of oil, we say that it's specific gravity times gamma of water. Specific gravity of oil is 0.88, I think. It's 0.88, right? It's 0.88, yeah. So it's 0.88. 0.88 times gamma of water. Gamma of water is 62.4 pound. Feet cube, right? Because we are using the PSI units. Yeah. This is 0.88 times 62.4, this is now gamma oil, times the H. H is 68 feet. Remember that this is pound per feet cube and this is feet, so the result is will be pound per feet square, right? Okay, now remember this is in what? Pound per inch square. PSI is the pound per inch square, right? Now, this is, should be converted. Pound per feet square should be converted to inch square. How to do that? Okay, we have feet, we have an inch, we have 1 foot is 12 inch. So squaring them, it means there will be like this. So feet square also will be with feet square. So the result will be, also, this is, will be PSI. Now we have pound per inch square. Okay, so the result is 32 plus, this is pound per inch square, plus 0.88 times 62.4 pound per times, sorry, times, 0.8 times 68 divided by 144, also power of n squared. This is will be the total pressure that we have it on the bottom of this. The tip will be 58 psi power per n squared. Okay. So we have a pipeline, we have a galley, and there will be, in addition to that galley, and the 68 feet depth of the oil, there will be, it means that that's the falling on this one. Okay, online students, do you have any question? Hi.
Doctor, what about the
other
side?
No, sir, thank you.
Okay, sorry. The other side?
Yeah, because it's affected on the, that point.
Okay.
It's like a U2.
You mean this point?
Yeah.
Now, the question says this is at rest, so it's not moving. So it means that this is the pipeline now, it has, it contains oil inside it and it stays not moving, it's at the rest. So we don't have, it means stabilized.
I know, but we have a flow which is creating a pressure.
Yeah, but it's not moving now. The oil here is not moving. It's not flowing. You got the question. The question is not flowing. We don't have the flow. In that case, there will be head loss. There will be a pressure loss from the point one to another point. For example, if you wanna see the pressure at this point, when it's moving, then there will be that pressure when the 58, as you say, 58 pound. So we found that at this point was 58 PSI. Now, if I wanna see exactly another pressure at this point, they are will not be the same. There will be a head loss or pressure loss from this point to that pressure, to that point. And later in other chapters, I will tell you how to find that head loss, that pressure loss. So the pressure at this point is equal to that pressure minus a something. That's called head loss. That head loss will basically is equal to F L over dV square over 2G. Now F is the friction. Maybe you have a pipe, frictionless, you have a very old pipe which has a very friction. So having friction, it means there's a restriction to move. It means that you need to spend more energy. There will be more head loss, energy loss. And having an L, here's L, the length, that's from this point to that point. More point means more, you need to spend more energy. You need to spend, there will be more losses. And also the diameter of this pipe, the diameter of this pipe, as much as, yeah, there will be an effect. And finally, the velocity of the flow of that. And as we don't have any velocity, it means this is zero, so they are the same. Yeah, we are going back to Pascal's, who say that there will be, when they are in the rest, they will be the same pressure. Okay? Now, this is what I told you. There is an example of, this is an open tank container, to contain 1.4 meter deep, covered by a 2 meter thick layer of oil. So we have two, this is oil. This is water. What is the specific gravity? It's 0.855. What's the specific gravity is here? It's one, for water is one. So I want to see how much is the pressure at the bottom of the tank in terms of water column. So the pressure at this point, the pressure is equal to first, the pressure that comes from the oil itself, so it's equal to H gamma oil, H oil, plus gamma water, H water. Now, how much is the gamma oil? It's a specific gravity, it's 0.855, and times gamma water, which is 9.81 kilonewton per meter cube. This is now gamma oil times the H of oil, which is 2 meter, plus gamma water, which is the 9.81 kilonewton per meter cube, times the edge of water, which is 1.4 meter. Okay, so more that will be that. This is called the gauge pressure. And as since it's not asking me to find, it's not mentioning find the gauge pressure, so you just need to find the gauge pressure. If you add more atmospheric pressure, there will be, this is will be an absolute pressure. So 9 times 2 to 20, here's the result. Okay. There is another, this is another example. We have 2 meters a liquid, and we have 5 meters a liquid, and look at the gamma. This is 8 kilonewton per meter cube. This is 10 kilonewton per meter cube at I and P. So the total pressure at point B will be equal to, first, this is called the interface. The pressure at interface, it means the column of that yellow part. So it means that 2 times 9.8, this is meter, this is 8, it's a kilonewton per meter cube. Now, so the result is 16 kilonewton per meter square, or 16 kilopascal. Now, this is for the interface. Down for the bottom, you should add them 8 times 2, this 8 times 2 plus this this 9 point, or it's 10, sorry, this is, should be 10. This is, should be 10. 10 times 5, it's equal to 50. 50 times 16, it means that 64 kilonewton by, so it's 66 kilonewton per meter square. I think it's easy, right? Now, also, if you have a column like this, this is the same thing that we have. I wanna go to the manometer. Now, piezometer and manometers are two devices that used, and we have them in the first lab one, right? They are used to measure the pressure at any point. Remember that we said the Pascal's first, is say that if you have a container like this, and you have a small pipe, which is the manometry, like that, and if they are connected together, so the pressure at this point will equal to the pressure at this point, right? So we are in manometry, what we are doing, we are using this device or this column to measure that, because so many times this is will be a great tank and it will be closed and we cannot see the elevation of the liquid at this point. So that's why we are using the manometry. So manometry is used to measure the pressure on this tank. And sometimes if you have more closed or maybe open to it. Now, what is the piezometer? The piezometer, it's also the manometry, but it used to you to measure also another kind of pressure, which is called velocity pressure. What does that mean? It means that if you have a pipe like this, and it has a flow inside this pipe. Okay, so because there is a flow, it means that this liquid has an energy to move, right? So if I have, let me say, I will put a manometry here. We have this one. This is an open. Now, it will give you arrays. This is called married. It will just measure the pressure that we have at this point. Okay. Now, if I, this is called manometer. If I used another device like the same, but now I will use this way. So the flow is coming here. It will make a pressure, another additional pressure on this one. So there will be more higher. This is called piezometer. So piezometer will measure also, and it will be put it in the middle way on the pipe diameter. That means that we need to see where is the maximum velocity in this pipe. It will be in the middle. So I will just focus the opening or the face of this manometer toward the point that we have it at that point. And that's why we say that piezometer is used for high pressure and moving liquid. By manometer, it will be just for a static pressure. This is the basic definitions of manometer. So manometer is used to measure the pressure and piezometer is to measure the velocity. And the idea is that the type of manometers that we have, here's the type of manometer. One of the first manometers type is called simple manometer. Means that if you have a tank, this is a tank, and I want to see the pressure inside this tank. So firstly, if this is a closed tank, right? If I come and I will just punch this tank by having a punch here. So what's gonna be happen? The level of this blue one will come here, right? They will be in the same level, right? Why? Because both of them are open to air. They will have to be the same as Pascal said, right? And now, but we have a difference in the elevation in this point and this point, right? Why this difference in elevation is there? Because we have a pressure at point A, it will pushing the liquid in this side to move this way more, right? This pushing or this pressure is the inside pressure that we have it at point A. Now, a simple manometer is used to measure that pressure. And how much it will be, since we have at point A, at any point in this part, till I will reach this point, there will be the same pressure. Now, we say that we know the pressure at this one, the atmospheric pressure. So the atmospheric pressure here is known, and we just need to, and remember in manometry, we have a rule. The rule is whenever you go down, you have to add pressure. Whenever you are going down, you have to add more pressure because I am here, I'm going down, so there will be more liquid above me, right? So I have to add more pressure when I'm in the lower level. But when you are here and you want to go upstairs, you are releasing pressure. So somebody is up having pressure less than me because he's up. So when you want to go up, then you have to detect, or let me say, make it pressureless. The room will be to be more easier. This is in this way it will be. If I have a pressure at this point, this is a pressure at point one, and this is a pressure at point two. So if I have a pressure at point one, and I want to go to find the pressure at point two. So remember, due to Pascal's law, this point will have the same pressure at this point, right? So pressure at point, and if I have this difference, H, so I say that the pressure at point two is equal to pressure at point one minus, because I'm going from bottom to the up, minus gamma H. Okay, this pressure is the column of the water that we have here. Okay, moreover, if I wanna see, this is the gauge pressure. So at point like A, I can see the pressure at point A will be the same at point one because they are having the same liquid, the same container. Now, so pressure at A is equal to the gamma. This, if I have air, if I have another liquid from A till one, let me make it out this way. So if I have the container A, the tank A is containing a liquid, so it will be filled till I'm reaching this point. So this is tank A. Tank A is containing a liquid, and this, there will be, for example, mercury. For example, we have a mercury at this point. Okay, now the definition is here. You have a point, that's point A. You wanna see how much is the pressure at point A. You have a mercury at G, and by the way, this is called manometric liquid. A liquid that's used to measure instead of water. Why we are usually using manometry? Because manometry specific gravity is 13.56. So one digit from manometry, it means 13.56 digits from water. It means that if the pressure was 1 meter of mercury, it looked like you need just to have a manometric of 1 meter depth if you are using mercury. But if you are using water, you need to have 13.56 long pipe just to fill that pipe with water. So that make not, this is making no sense to have to use this kind of, because that's why we are using a small a pipe with a liquid that having a heavy weight or like a specific gravity more than water. And we have another definitions, we have another properties for that liquid. The liquid should be not react neither to the liquid that we have it in the tank nor with the atmosphere. So we don't need any interaction between the liquid. We don't need to have a liquid that will be for example, affected by temperature, by pressure, by the body of this, for example, of this pipe itself. There should not be any interaction. That's why mercury is the best one that still now they are using it. It's not active. Again, back to what we have. I want to see how much is the pressure at point A. To find the pressure of point A, we have a liquid, this is gamma or Z, or let me say the depth of point A. Till point one, if it was Z, so the pressure at point one is equal to the pressure at point A minus, because I'm going from A to point one. So whenever you are going down, sorry, you have to add, sorry. Whenever you are going up, you have to make it negative. So I will say pressure at point one and the relation with the pressure at point A. What is the relation? The relation is pressure at point one is equal to pressure at A plus how much is the other liquid that we have, Z. Let me say this is gamma. I don't know. Let me say this is gamma yellow. Okay, times gamma yellow. Means that when you have this pressure, you want to measure the point at A pressure, you have just to, by the way, pressure at A, I will just add this column of yellow liquid to that one, I will get it. And I can go directly to the same level for the opposite side of this liquid. So I will say there is another point that's here, which is point two. Now, the pressure at point one is equal to the pressure at point two. Why? Because they are on the same level. Okay. If I want to see the pressure at point three, the pressure at point three is equal to what? The pressure at point three, in terms of pressure at point two, is equal to pressure at point two minus, because I'm going up, minus how much? If this is was H, so it means that it means gamma of the brown, or let me mercury, times, if this is was mercury, times H. Because I am going to lift the pressure at from point two to point three. So I'm lifting or making less pressure because I'm going from bottom to the up. That's the idea. This is the principles of using manometry. Manometry is usually you have to know where you are going from which point to which point. That's why we are using the pressure to measure. I don't know why it's clear. So look at this one. I want to see, this is, I said, a manometric liquid reading. And this is why it's called the reading, manometric, the difference. We are using this kind of manometry just to measure the pressure at a specific tank, a specific point. While we have, this is the idea of having, so this is the atmospheric pressure. Atmospheric pressure, so the absolute pressure is equal to atmospheric pressure at A. So I want to see how much is the, this is the gauge pressure. The gauge pressure at A is equal to gamma H minus this one. So pressure at A, this is pressure at A, I know that one. And I'm going from A to this interface, so I should add, because this is the direction. Then I will pass from this point to that point, they will have the same, and I will go up. It means that I should make a negative. How much is the negative value? Is the Y. So I should multiply Y by this type of liquid, and this type of liquid is gamma manometry. And that's equal to zero because we are balanced, not this is a static. So be aware that we have sign conversion. Whenever you have upward direction, you have to make it in negative. Downward direction, you have to make it positive value. That was the first type of manometry that's used just to measure pressure at a specific time. What if I have two tanks like this? Two tanks, and the two tanks are on the same level. So what I will just connect between them. Yes, I'm connecting between them by using a manometry. This kind is called differential manometry. It's just give me a delta P, or let me, how much is the difference between the pressure in both tanks? Now, if the pressure at A is equal to pressure at B, it means there is Y equal, it should equal to zero, right? But it's now not equal to zero because we have the pressure at A is greater or it will be greater than pressure at B. Why? There is a push from A towards the B. That's why we have the level here is, the pressure here is more than this one. That's why it make the level, it's unbalanced and it stay in this way. Now, let's go and use the same idea of calculating the pressure. I will use the same idea. I will move from a point, which is point A, to point B. So I will say pressure at point A, it will be equal to, go back. So pressure at B, I'm going from B to this point. So it means I should add, how much I should add? Plus ZB, this distance is ZB. So it means gamma H. So ZB multiplied by the gamma of the liquid that we have in tank AB. So ZB times gamma B, and it should be added. Why? Because I'm going from B, and so the idea is I'm going from B to A. Pressure at B, I will come here. So the pressure at this point is equal to B plus gamma H. Now I will come to this point. So I should add more. The pressure at this point is equal to the pressure at this point plus this weight. So that's why I will add more. More what? More as Y. We have Y. What is the liquid that I added, the pressure that I added? That was the green one or the manometric one. So that's gamma M. Now I reached this point. So no need to go down because this point's pressure is the same as this point's pressure. So I will jump to that one. Now I wanna go up. So it should be in minus. How much it should be? We have ZA. And we have the gamma, which is for tank A. So gamma H, gamma Z, that will give you a pressure at A. And I reached point A. It means that now we have. Now the difference in the pressure, it basically PA minus PB. So just I wanna move this one, this PB to the left side of the equation. I will get PA minus PB, which is the delta pressure. And this delta pressure is equal to ZA times gamma B plus Y times gamma manometry minus ZA times gamma A. Now, what if Y is equal to zero? Then there will be a kind of, if ZA and ZB are the same, and they are the same liquid, so it means that we have Y equal to zero. This is called differential manometer. So differential manometer is used just to measure the pressure between two tanks. The third one is that we have the third kind, when we have also two, it's called differential manometer, but the tanks are not in the same level. So when we have, they are not in the same level, we have to use the same thing. We are going from A to B. So I wanna go from A to B, or I will say, when I wanna see how much is the pressure at A, I will go from pressure at B. Pressure at B minus ZB. Y minus, plus, sorry. So pressure at B, this is pressure at B. I'm going from B till I will reach this point. How much is the vertical distance? ZB. So ZB times its gamma. Gamma B. Now I reach this point. Now again, I will go down till I will reach this point. So I should add more. Add gamma manometry with the Y, which is equal to. Now I will go from, I will reach this point. I reach that point, so I will jump to this one, and I will say they are the same, and I will go up. How much to go up? I will go to point A, which is the vertical distance, which is ZA, times the gamma of A. So also I will say PA minus PB will give you the same equation, or there will be the same. Okay. This is another one kind of manometric that's used to find the differential. The last one is we have also a manometric, it's called inverted. Inverted manometry. We have inverted, we have inclined, we have this is also, the idea is you are going to find the pressure at point A. So what we do, I will go from B to A. So I'll start moving from A, I will go up. It means that the pressure at B, yes. Now I'm going up, it means that I should put negative sign. Right? How much is the distance that we go up, that we are going up, is ZB. So that means minus, I'm releasing pressure. Going up, it means that you have to make it minus ZB, the vertical descent, times the gamma. Now, also I will go from this point to that point. Also, I should put another negative. How much is the distance, is Y. Times the gamma manometry. Now I reach this point, which is means I'm going here, jump. Now I'm going down, so I have to add the vertical distance from this point to that point is ZA. So I will multiply ZA by gamma. Easy? Okay, now the third one I have to use it, so we will solve the examples next lecture. Okay, now we have the idea, we have the rules, how to go and where to go, and how should I put the negative sign, how should I add the positive sign. Okay.
Do you have problems?
No, problem. So now you can leave. Yeah, I think so.
Sir, can I ask a question?
Yes.
In the one where they're at the same level, the differential.
Yes.
If the liquids are the same, why can't we just use the difference of the mercury?
This one means?
Yes, if we have the same.
This one. Yeah, the same liquid for both A and B.
Yes. Why can't we just multiply the Y by the gamma of mercury? That's the difference in pressure that they
use. Yeah, that will be, yeah. Just you have to multiply the gamma manometry by the Y, it will give you the difference. Abdurrahman?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Sara? Yeah. Zaria? Yeah. Renas? Zaniar?
Yes.
Ravusht? Soma Hushyar. Shia.
Yes, sir.
Darian.
Yes, sir.
Suryan. Awin.
Yes, sir.
Mir Mahdi. Mir. Kaja. Zivan?
Yes, sir.
Berham? Mako? Muhammad?
Yes.
Qabas? Balen? Mestan? Mestan? Rana? Rana?
Yes.
Okay, Binar?
Binar? Yes, sir. Yes.
Niloufar? Niloufar? Behman?
Yes.
Nifar? Nifar? Zahra? Aros? Aros? Rawant? Rawant? Lawant? Lawant? Peri? Peri Kemal? Sima?
Yes.
Abdullah? Abdullah Farhat? Dilan? Dilan? Asma?
Yes.
Anita? Anita? Zerdasht? Zerdasht? Okay. Baku? Baku Khalid?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Okay. Irina?
Yes.
Thank you.
Sir?
Yes?
You didn't call my name.
Who?
You didn't call my name.
Who's talking?
Renaz?
Renaz, I called you.
Sir, mine too.
Okay, I will add you. Renaz, I will add you.
Sir, what about mine?
Who's that?
Soma.
Soma, also I asked, I called you, but you didn't ask me. Yeah, I will add Soma. Soma and Renaz. Yes.
Thank you, sir.
Tamam. 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 Tamam